Recently, it was revealed that the retail hotel chain Motel 6 had been turning over their guest registers to ICE officials. The Immigration and Customs Enforcement officers were voluntarily being given this information by Motel 6, which was a very clear violation of the rights of the people staying in those hotels, regardless of their legal status. This decision by the Motel 6 to do this resulted in the invasion of privacy of these people and also resulted in unnecessary harassment. Motel 6 has settled with some of the victims, and I'm joined now by Scott Hardy from Top Class Actions to help explain what happened in this particular instance. So Scott, let's jump right in. Motel 6 is turning over this information to ICE agents, completely not legal in this particular instance, is it? I mean, ICE would have to come in with a warrant or a court order in order to be able to get this information, yet Motel 6 just handed it over for no apparent reason.
Right. It's really scary that you would have a motel chain that is well-respected, and, you know, unfortunately, when they said, we'll keep the light on, they actually meant we'll keep the light on for the ICE agents to find you, whether or not you're here legally. So, you know, it's horrendous violation of privacy when you have people who are of Hispanic descent who are just going to try to spend the night somewhere, and all of a sudden they're getting a knock on their door from ICE agents and possibly deported simply because they chose to go ahead and go to Motel 6 to spend the night. Just the blatant breach of privacy and the racism inherent is disgusting.
And so Motel 6 has agreed to a major settlement, I think about a little over $6.5 million to those who were affected. And there's kind of different tiers here with this settlement too. You know, if you were just had your information turned over, about $50. But if you were actually interrogated and possibly deported, you're entitled to a lot more than just that $50, correct?
Exactly. And it's interesting. With this class action lawsuit, you see, well, you could get $7,500 back if you were deported. I mean, you have to understand that the $5 or $6 million this settlement is worth is because not many of those people will be claiming their money. They're already back in Mexico or Central America or wherever they were deported to. So that $7,500 they could actually claim will be very difficult to get to. You know, if you were detained by ICE, you can get $1,000 if you're detained in question simply because you look Hispanic, then you'll be able to get some cash back. But that $7,500 number won't really help you much if you're sitting in an ICE jail cell right now waiting to get sent back.
Absolutely. And one of the worst parts about this, which, you know, is kind of what we saw when they had the stop and frisk policies in certain areas of the country, it's demeaning. It's embarrassing, it's humiliating, and yet that's what this hotel, Motel 6, they put their own customers through that. I mean, I guess maybe they thought they were trying to help with the immigration issue in the United States, but for the life of me, I cannot figure out what the motivation here would have been for these hotels to turn this information over to ICE.
Right, I agree with you, and I think that if you look up the executives, you know, the executives who are actually in charge of Motel 6, this must have been somebody who was not, you know, who got in the fervor in our immigration crackdown right now and sent it down, because Motel 6 as a chain is well respected as clean rooms and a decent place to stay if you've got to go ahead and you're looking for one. It was frankly shocking that any hotel or any motel chain would issue any sort of directive saying call ICE. All these hotels, if there's something illegal going on, they will absolutely call and try to get local police assistance. But to have that directive come down from management and state, if someone is Hispanic and you think they might be here illegally, call ICE on them, that's just frankly shocking.
Absolutely. It almost just seems mean and vindictive at that point. I mean, if they had issues possibly with somebody's legal status, you know, that's an issue for another day. You know, you take that up, maybe you can report it and say, hey, this person did not have an ID. Perhaps that's something they should look into. But to just immediately go to calling ICE saying, hey, this person looks like they could be illegal. That's absolutely, absolutely disgusting for this chain to do that and to engage in this behavior.
It really is. I mean, it shouldn't be a crime in America to speak Spanish.
Right.
And that's what it boils down to. If they were speaking Spanish and their English wasn't great, there is a good chance they're going to get ice cold on them. And that's, thankfully, that is not a crime in America, at least not yet.
Right. And there's plenty of people who are 100% U.S. citizens who do not speak English as their first language. And so this hotel was engaging in the racial profiling, again, humiliating these guests, some of whom obviously were 100% U.S. citizens. And yet they still treated them like this because they got caught up in that immigration, illegal immigrant fervor that unfortunately has been drummed up in this country today. And there's more information available about this settlement. The link is in the description to this video. It'll take you to topclassactions.com where you can find out more. Scott Hardy, thank you very much for talking with us today.
Thanks for your time, Farron. Appreciate it.